Hello, I'm Brandy Eckerbeck of loosetooth.com, and I help you reclaim drawing as your best thinking tool so you can see and shape your life and your work in new ways. And today is Studio Tuesday, and my studio today is my home. I'm reporting from my couch and very excited about what happened last week, what's happening this week and next week and the week after. So I very quickly, I just had the calendar run in my head. I just very quickly want to tell you a couple quick announcements about where I'm at, where I'm going. And then I want to talk about how I used the stack to help produce my talk last week, the last video you may have seen, and how I'm using it in preparation for what's happening next week. So quickly, first I have to show you, I made this necklace this last weekend and I am pretty much in love with it. So I had this idea about these different halves, plastic halves of beads. And this is one that has glitter inside of it. This is, you know, I love hands-on making. I love being resourceful and figuring out like how to solve for something. So I had these plastic halves and I had some other beads. And these are things I've had around forever. And I finally made them into this magnificent giant bobbly sort of jawbreaker of a necklace, and it makes this gorgeous plasticky noise. So that's just a shout out to my new favorite thing, which is this necklace I made. So this necklace will be going to with me to Germany tomorrow. So I am currently at home in Chicago. Tomorrow I head to Germany. Very, very, very happy that I've been invited as one of the Neuland ambassadors to help them celebrate their 50th birthday. So Neuland, the fantastic company that makes amazingly beautifully produced, that's quite the effusive string of words. Wonderful, wonderful, solid products for visual facilitation. They make pin boards, they produce the best markers, all sorts of fantastic tools. A couple of them you will see in this project I'm about to describe. But very excited to help celebrate with them on Saturday, and then on Monday and Tuesday next week, teaching 2 one-day classes. Teaching is where it's at. While I love being the one person in the room drawing for a group of people, I love, love, love teaching everyone these skills for themselves so all of us can see and shape our work. So very excited to head to Germany tomorrow. So currently I'm in that, like, you know, day before the flight, packing and organizing and tying up loose ends and all that. So couple of the things I'm organizing, not so much for Germany, but after that, I come back home and I teach the lab, and I love the lab. And I know I've talked about the lab plenty of times before, but very quickly, it's a 3-day immersion into visual thinking through the lens of graphic facilitation. Now, the through the lens part means that we are practicing visual thinking by drawing large and live for those 3 days. And so right now I'm in that very happy place where it's like, oh, there's a lab coming. I get to work with 6 people for 3 days and we get to completely nerd out. And for me, you know, I love the nerding out part, but I love seeing how much the 6 people learn and grow and push themselves and challenge themselves. Oh my goodness, it is just the front row seat for the most awesome thing. And part of that, you know, another joy of mine is really setting up the environment for their success. And this environment works in a few different ways. One is the physical space. Another are having fantastic materials to work with. So yes, in this case, every person gets a kit. Those kits are filled with Neuland markers. And, you know, they get this kit to use in those 3 days, take home and continue using. You know, so some of it's the physical stuff, but a lot of it is how the space is facilitated and hosted. So, you know, I'm excited that, you know, I'm excited for just getting the stuff that we need to make it happen. But the intangible stuff is, you know, how do I facilitate? How, introducing everybody before the workshop happens, what questions I ask so people can get to know each other. How do I help welcome people in when they, you know, when they actually join me on, in this case, October 17th. But really, and also just what I super love is that unlike the workshops next week, these workshops are emergent. This workshop is emergent. The lab is emergent. So I start with one specific exercise, but then everything else is emergent and adaptive to what those six people need. And what I take great pride in is that that space is both safe and challenging. So it is an opportunity to push yourself, to experiment, to get your hands on different ideas, different techniques, trying new things. And yet it is a safe space to be vulnerable, do weird stuff, have things not work, talk about that stuff not working, and really learning from each other. So that is what I'm so excited to be participating in a couple weeks, is hosting, not participating in, but helping host or lead that lab. And so that is right around the corner, nerding out. And I've got three labs open for 2019. So those labs are open. Registration is waiting for you. So in 2019, there are 18 spots to work with me in three labs. So six people per lab. One spot has filled. So 17 ready and raring and waiting for you. So please go to loosetooth.com/lab for all the details and see if that opportunity is right for you. So again, right now here in Chicago, it's about preparing for the lab, preparing for next week's workshops. And a bow I am tying on last week is I wanted to describe to you how I used the stack to organize the speech you may have seen me give last week. So I very happily had an invitation from Rosamund and Jasmine of Miss Spoken, which is a live Lady Lit series here in Chicago. And go to miss-spoken.com for all the details on the series and listen to the podcast for hours and past archives of the talks. The idea is that it's about a 5 to 10 minutes on a specific topic. And last week's topic was show and tell. And show and tell was about visual, how to tell your story visually. And of course I said yes, but then I had to figure out what the heck was I gonna say? How was I gonna organize it? And I was using, you know, practicing what I preach, using visual tools to figure out what the heck I wanted to say, how I wanted to use that time on that stage in front of that audience. So this was the very first iteration of what the heck I was going to do, was this scribbly piece of paper with some lines on it as I'm working out what the heck the shape of this thing is. So it took just some that really awkward feeling of like, I don't really know what I'm going to do. I guess I'm going to figure it out. And then the next step was to use a stack. Now the stack is, instead of a landscape where you're drawing out all your things on one piece of paper, a stack is about putting one idea per piece of paper. And so the idea is that the modularity of the stack is its power. And truly, this was the, these were the cards where I was working out exactly what my talk was going to be. So the great thing about this was that I could just make very simple little thumbnails of each of the slides. So in this case, you know, I'm thinking about it slides. It's working like a slide deck, but really I was making physical pieces of paper that I was presenting from. So I'll put a link below if you didn't see that video. But basically I was talking about the lines we draw in relationships. So, you know, that was the sketch of the two circles and the line connecting them. And this was the actual physical drawing that I held in front of me as I gave that speech last week. So the great thing about the stack was it's modularity. It's very adaptable. It's very flexible. So it helped me not only, I mean, literally, you know, there was a stack that I was presenting with, you know, much like we use PowerPoint slides or keynote slides. Not only was it part of the presentation, but it also really helped me clarify what I wanted to say and how I wanted to say it. So I was putting these ideas down on these cards, and then I had the opportunity to move them around. Now it just happens, this is the final stack, so I pulled out the cards I didn't use. But as I practiced, you know, small scale with these cards, you know, I would recite and flip the card and flip the card and flip the card. It helped me see how long the piece was and where I might need to cut and bring down the time and shorten the piece to make it more concise and more on topic. So I used the stack, literally to figure out what is the sequence, what is the pacing, what is the scope of the speech. And then I transferred those same thumbnails onto these 11 by 17 pieces of paper. Now, in this particular case, I used Neuland sticky notes for the circles for the faces. So these are these round sticky notes that Neuland makes in different colors. In this case, I just used the light yellow color. Honestly, it was just because it wasn't so important that each of these yellow circles was drawn by hand. So why not use a simple tool to make those specific faces, right? So that is exactly how I used the stack for last week's talk. It is exactly how I'm preparing for next week's workshops. So in this case, not so much the physical. I am now working with electronically in PowerPoint. I've got my progression of how I'm going to lead the workshop. Now, believe me, it's not going to be, you know, it's 2 one-day workshops. It's not going to be 16 hours of PowerPoint. Forget it. It will start, the Idea Shaper Tour will start with a quick-paced tour through the 24 Idea Shapers, and then there's occasional parts where I may project to supplement what I'm doing live in the room. But the same thing you got here with the deck. When I'm in slide view, I'm able to see each of those individual pieces of content and how do I want to sequence them? How do I want to tell the story? How do I want to lead people through that workshop? So highly recommend if you are stumped, if you are stuck, if something feels messy and weird and fuzzy, and you're not sure how to approach a speech, a paper, a presentation, a workshop, writing a book, many, many, many things, grab a stack of index cards, grab a stack of blank index cards, and just start getting down one idea per post-it note. That's all you have to do first, is just get the stuff down. Do not worry if there's too much stuff. Do not worry if stuff is on topic or not on topic, because that's the beauty of the stack. First version of the stack, generative. Just get stuff on paper. Great thing about the stack is you can always have some in your bag or in your pocket, and you can pull them out, and you know, anytime you have a new idea, put one idea per post-it or per index card, in this case index card. That's it. That's super simple instructions, just one idea per index card, per slip of paper, per sticky note, per post-it note, and then you can step back and you can sort and you can shuffle and you can sequence and you can shape and figure out exactly what shape does that speech, does that paper, does that presentation, or does that workshop, or that book, or whatever it is, does it take once you've got kind of all the pieces out on these little slips of paper. So that is exactly how I wrangled last week's speech and literally used a stack to also present it. And that is exactly how I'm shaping next week's workshops. So that is the report from the front, this Studio Tuesday here in Chicago. What's there to say? Happy birthday, Neuland. Hip hip hooray. Again, if you want to join me in the lab, that's loosetooth.com/lab. And I look forward to seeing you next time, probably from Germany next week. So.